Welcome to Back to Basics. I am Gerardo Estava, and today we're going to talk about the basics of protecting your network in the cloud. Great network security looks a lot like an onion, a beautifully designed vegetable that protects itself through multiple layers that if you try to break into, you'll end up crying. We want to apply the same layer approach to network security so that all of these layers block the traffic that's not intended to the application. So let's get started on some patterns for protecting your network in the cloud. Let's start with a simple architecture example, a single Amazon EC2 instance. The best way to protect the network access to the instance is by configuring its security group. A security group acts as a virtual firewall for your instance network interface. With security groups, you can configure inbound rules and outbound rules. These rules specify sources, protocols, and ports that you want to allow traffic from. An important thing to consider is that security groups are stateful. If an inbound request is allowed by the inbound rules, then the response outbound traffic for that connection is automatically allowed. So what sort of sources, protocols, and ports should you allow in your security group? Of course, the minimum necessary for the intended operation of the instance. You can use security groups to allow any network protocol, but if all you want is to allow web traffic from the internet, we can improve our security and availability by adding an elastic load balancer in front of it. Elastic load balancers add many benefits, such as the ability to distribute traffic across multiple instances, such as handling failover among them, but also adding security benefits like, for example, implementing a web application firewall. By implementing a load balancer, you're effectively adding one layer to our onion, abstracting your instances from the outside world, removing direct access from the internet to your instance, and you can configure a security group for the load balancer as well. So far, these resources exist in our Amazon Virtual Private Cloud, or VPC. A VPC gives you your own dedicated and isolated virtual private network with complete control over your IP address ranges, gateways, subnets, and other network constructs. Another way of adding a layer to our onion is by implementing different subnets. For example, if we add an Amazon RDS database to our architecture with no need for internet access, then it can be placed in a private subnet that has no route to or from the internet. Traffic between subnets can only occur if the VPC route table and the network access control list allow it. An access control list, or NACL, is an optional firewall layer between subnets. As opposed to security groups, NACLs are stateless, meaning that if we want our instances to talk to our database, we need to explicitly allow traffic from subnet A to subnet B, and also from subnet B to subnet A. If we want our instances to make outbound connections to the internet, instead of configuring direct access, we can add one layer by introducing an AWS managed NAT gateway. NAT gateways allow for traffic initiated from private subnets to reach the internet, but prevents traffic initiating from the internet to reach our instances. If your instance needs to communicate with other AWS services, instead of allowing traffic to or from the internet, you can use VPC endpoints. VPC endpoints allow private connections from your VPC to AWS services like Amazon S3 or DynamoDB, or even other services that can be exposed by AWS private link. You can configure endpoint policies to specify the traffic that you want to allow through VPC endpoint. We can also protect network access at the edge. Amazon CloudFront is a fast content delivery network, or CDN. Configuring a CloudFront distribution in front of our load balancer is a good idea so that we speed up the delivery of content to our users, while at the same time adding another layer of network security with advanced TLS capabilities. We can also block direct internet access to our load balancer to enforce access via CloudFront. CloudFront also works well with other edge protection services that are worth adding to our onion. AWS Web Application Firewall, or WAF, to protect against common web exploits, and AWS Shield, protect from distributed denial of service, or DDoS, events.
So there you have it. We've added several layers of network security to our onion. Each layer aims to allow only the network traffic that is expected by the application. This layer approach mitigates the impact of a misconfiguration in one of the layers that could end up in unintended access. So keep building securely, and I'll see you next time.